have gotten so lush and green in here.
There's so much to see and discover as we make our way back to the ocean.
Here we are at Learning Circle 2, the second stop on our investigation into the path of our raindrop as it moves down the watershed on its way back to the sea.
Let's see if we can find any water coming out of the ground.
We've just come from the top of our watershed, where our raindrop first touches the surface of the earth, either in solid form, as snow or ice, or in liquid form, as rain, thanks to the force of gravity. Gravity is the force that pulls all objects towards the center of the planet. If it weren't for gravity, everything would just float off into space.
Our raindrop will always seek the path of least resistance. That means it will find the easiest way downhill.
That's pretty heavy. Get it? Gravity? Heavy? Come on.
Funny. All right, enough of that. This is where water first comes out of the ground and is also released back into the air from plants.
That happens through the three processes we mentioned earlier. One, where water soaks into the surface, called infiltration. Another, that moves our raindrop through the ground, called percolation. And yet another, where it's drawn up through plants and released back into the air through their leaves as a gas, called transpiration.
It's taken our raindrop about a day to travel underground from the top of our watershed, running past roots and stones, moving around worms and other creatures, right here under our feet.
Our raindrop is joined by others as they come out of the ground as a spring and proceed downhill as a small stream. I've noticed some changes since we left the meadow and gone down the watershed. How about you, Ava?
Well, let's see. There are tons more trees, there's lots more shade, the trees are much larger, and there's a ton more plant life. Is that what you mean?
You got it. Our raindrop soaks into the ground quicker, leaves the upper part of the watershed faster, and can stay in the ground longer the further down we go. See those huge Sitka spruces over there? And the smaller ones with the white bark? The alders? The Sitka spruces are evergreens, and the alders are deciduous.
Evergreens have been on Earth the longest, dating back some 300 million years. They have needles or leaves that usually stay green year-round. Deciduous trees are the relative newcomers, dating back about 140 million years. They drop their leaves at the end of the growing season and sprout new ones in the spring. Scientists have found that deciduous trees, like alders, can support the growth of evergreens, like the Sitka spruce. They contribute significant amounts of nutrient-rich minerals and other elements when their leaves fall to the ground and decay. Deciduous trees also have a greater capacity than evergreens to capture carbon dioxide and nitrogen from the air and soil and convert them into nutrients. They prepare the ground for other trees as the forest grows up around them. Alder trees also provide essential food and habitat for deer, birds, and fish.
It's really interesting to know how all of these wonderful plants and animals help each other thrive in this marvelous place.
Mm-hmm. You know, it's really all about balance in this little piece of paradise.
Let's talk about transpiration, the way that our raindrop is taken up by plants and released into the atmosphere. Clearly, it's moving upwards against the forces of gravity.
Plants contain a vast network of tiny pathways that transport water and nutrients in the same way blood moves through our bodies. These tiny pathways are present throughout the plant, starting in their roots, moving up through their trunks, into their branches, and out every leaf.
As water transpires through their leaves, plants pull up additional water from their roots, lifting it higher and higher, replacing water that evaporates into the air. This action is similar to pulling a drink of water up through a straw. The tree is literally pulling up and breathing moisture out into the atmosphere.
Did you know that transpiration also occurs in humans?
Yeah, but how does that even happen? We don't even have leaves.
Well, it happens in two ways. Through our mouths, because we lose a lot of moisture when we breathe, and through our skin, when we perspire.
Oh, do you mean sweat?
Precisely. Perspiration is similar to what trees do when they transpire. It's all pretty amazing when you think about it. So where's our raindrop heading now?
Well, I think I see something just through the trees over there. Your answer to your question might lie just ahead. Shall we go investigate further?
Absolutely.
Speaking of alders, how did you get your name, Alder? Are you deciduous?
Well, that's a funny story. It all starts out in Klickitat, Washington.